Hello everyone. Today we will be discussing session 2 of unit 3, which relates to documents required for stock handling. So in any retail organization, stock handling is very important. In order to have a smooth inventory management in an organization and to run a retail unit successfully, a retailer has to determine various stock levels and maintain it. So usually our stock arrives at the retail store through trucks or through containers. So in any way, which way that it arrives at the stock at our warehouses, we have to be very careful about dealing with it. So when stock arrives at the retail store, it usually arrives in a truck or in a container which needs to be unloaded. Documents are required for entering and maintaining information regarding the stock. So before we start unloading our products or our items, and before we start checking into the documents, there are certain points that a retailer needs to note before starting the unloading process. So a retailer should ensure that the stock is sorted as per the retail store's requirements. So if you remember our earlier sessions, we have certain goods that have to be kept carefully because they are perishable. Certain goods have expiry dates. So we have to sort them out as per the retail store requirements. The stock is then recorded as per the retail store procedures. So whatever procedures that we have to maintain in a particular store, we will start recording the stock as per that. Then the stock is checked as per the required documentation. So we start unloading our stock and we start checking if whatever we have received is as per what we have ordered. The difference between the actual stock received and invoiced order stock are identified and reported according to the retail store procedures. So we start checking that whatever we have ordered, is it actually what we have received? And if there is any problem in between, like we have ordered and we've not received it, or we have received more than we have ordered, that we have to identify. And then the relevant documentation is completed as per the retail store procedures. The retail organization systems for receiving and maintaining stock levels must be appropriate. So you should have a system which is accurate so that you at any point do not get proper or improper reporting of your stock. And the goods should be available when required. So whenever the customer requires it, you should have that ready to be displayed or to be sold. And the goods must be fit for use and ready to use. So the goods should be in proper, without any expiry dates, it should not be damaged, and it should be proper, ready to be used by the customer. And the method employed is cost effective, and the wastage has to be minimum. You want to avoid any kind of wastage or have to make it cost effective so that you do not have any losses. So now we come to the documents which are prepared while stock handling. The first document that we're looking at is delivery note. A delivery note is usually supplied with the goods at the time of delivery, and it states what the supplier has actually delivered to the store. So we may have ordered some things, and whatever items that we have ordered, that the supplier has sent to us. And along with that, the supplier has sent us a note which says whatever items have been delivered to us. So the goods delivered are checked against the delivery note to confirm the delivery is correct. So we are looking at our particular items or boxes of items or whatever we have received from the supplier. And then we look at the delivery note and we check that whatever has been sent to us is absolutely as per the delivery note. So a delivery note looks something like this. It is also called a delivery challan in India. So it would have the buyer's information, it would have the supplier's information, and it would have all the details of what products or what goods have been sent to the retailer, in what quantity and in what amounts and rates. So you would have all the details about whatever products you have ordered, what has been sent to you. The next document that we are looking at is invoice. Invoice is a legal document that is used at the time of dispatching and delivering the goods to the customer. So the invoice would have all the information about the goods, like the quantity and the nature of goods. And the invoice is very important document as it is used to bill the receiving company. So you would have an invoice like this, where you would have all the information. So the buyer's information, the seller's information, and you would have the description of what particular products have been sent to the retailer or sent to the customer. What are the taxes that have been added to it, and what is the actual amount? So you would have all these figures, and this is what you would be actually used to bill the customer or the consumer. Next document that we are looking at is the consignment note. The consignment note is used when the delivery is out to a private carrier. It shows what goods are and issued by the carrier for delivery. So there is an actual transportation happening here, and the supplier has given all the products to a carrier. It could be a truck company, it could be a courier company, and these goods are being transported by the carrier to the retailer. So it is a record of what has actually been sent through the private carrier. It shows the number of containers, boxes, bales or bags of goods. And the goods in the consignment note, they can be checked with other delivery documents as well. So a consignment note would look something like this, where you have a consignment note number, you would have a from and delivered to, and all the list of the items, a bit of a description of the items, so that you can see that this is what the receiver has received and in what condition. Next, we would have an internal packing note. It is used to carry more detail of the stock delivered. It gives the details of outer containers such as bags, cartons, drums, boxes and pallets. So whatever has been packed inside these containers, that would be mentioned in our internal packing notes. So it would have specific information like the quantity, type, size, specification and colors. It would look something like this. So you would have your packing note, which would give you a description of all your items, whatever is in that container. So there would be different products, like products 1, 2, 3, and how much quantity you should expect in that particular container. So it could be product like shirts or socks in different packages, and how many shirts, like there would be 10 shirts in that particular carton. So all of that would be mentioned in a packing. We also have electronic data systems that make our life easier. Instead of having handwritten bills and invoice notes or whatever documents, we could have an electronic data system where retailers use a special computer for receiving of consignments of goods using an automated system. The automated systems, they cut down on the paperwork, and they're very quick in image checking and transferring information. So using a scanner, you are scanning the products, and that information is stored in the computer. And that information which is stored in the computer can be accessed by the retailer to check what the stock levels are, what has been received, was it what that was ordered. So all this can make life easier for the retailer. So the features of an automated system are: the consignment note is a proof of the delivery sent through a computer. The consignment note contains barcodes and the barcoded delivery labels. So it would be something like this. There would be a barcode mentioned on that particular label. You would have a consignment note that has been recorded in the computer, and that can be scanned and received at the retailer's end. The consignment note has barcodes like displayed here, and the delivery labels can be identified. So you can scan this barcode. Once it is scanned, all that information is stored in the computer and you can cross-check it. So we have a procedure for checking stock levels. In the process of checking stock levels of different products in a retail store, if any variations or problems are identified, it is the role of the store operation assistant to report it to the competent authority. So if you find some deviation, that there is a problem with whatever we've ordered and what we have received, let us see how we can sort of sort it out. So the various remedies which are available to rectify the deviation in the supplies are as follows. We can ask for a replacement. So we've ordered something, it has damaged, or we don't have it in the, like I ordered a particular shade of t-shirts, like I ordered white t-shirts and they have sent me black t-shirts. So I can ask for a replacement. Credit, we can ask for it to be credited, like we can ask for the goods to be sold to us on credit and we can pay for it later. We can dispose of the products which are not appropriate. They've reached the expiry date. They're so damaged they cannot be used. We can dispose of them. We can sell them off as seconds. Supposing they are, you know, clothing items or electronic items which have slight defects, like a bit of, you know, a color mismatch or a bit of, thread is not okay. So you can sell them off as seconds. You can tell the customer about it and sell it, keeping the customer informed. You can repair and charge it to the supplier. So if there is some problem with the products that can be repaired, we can repair it and charge it to the supplier, or we can return it altogether to the supplier. So we have all these remedies, and we have on display here now a sample stock report where you can see the product IDs, the product categories, the particular brand they are, what is the product name, what is the code that we are maintaining it against, how many items we have, how many items have been sold or been sent to the shop floor, how many items have been booked by the customer, how many have been out on delivery, what is the balance, and what is the minimum order quantity. So we have a total stock in hand. We can look at it and maintain our stock levels and keep an eye on our stock levels. So if there are any deviations that we see, if any stock level is less or more than what we need to report it. So when a delivery is incorrect or damaged, a damage or a shortage report must be completed. So when we are looking at a damage or shortage report, this is something that we are noting down and we are also informing our supplier. So it should include the date on which damaged goods are received, the shortage that occurred during delivery. So on which date we received these goods and they were damaged, the shortage, like supposing we ordered 100 items, we received only 99. So we have to mention that as well. Whether the goods failed to arrive at the stipulated time. So we ordered the goods on, say, the 10th of the month and we received it on the 15th of the month. So we have to mention that as well. So these kind of deviations have to be mentioned in our report. So today we discussed about the documents in our stock handling and how a retailer has to be careful about maintaining stock levels and maintain the documentation regarding the stock levels as well. So I hope this session was helpful for you. And if there are any questions, do feel free to ask. So thank you and have a lovely day.